Hey y'all, it's Betsy with Happily Ever After, etc. And welcome back to a garden haul video. So I went to an estate sale with my mom last weekend, also 2 weekends ago. And we ended up getting quite a bit of garden things. Some are in the pile here, some are in a pile behind y'all. And then I got not one, but 2 fountains in the last 2 weeks. So 2 separate estate sales. I'll show you the one I got from this haul and the one I got before that. But for this haul, I ended up paying, technically the fountain itself, it is a 2-tiered concrete fountain, about $100. And everything else was, it was $50 for everything, and I got about half and mom got about half. So like, and that includes all of this stuff right here, a concrete bird bath, a whole tub full of like tchotchkes. It was a good sale. So I'm just gonna start showing you, but just remember, if we count everything, the concrete fountain, concrete bird bath, and everything else I'm gonna show you, I paid $150 for everything, which the fountain alone, I looked it up and I found it from a shop. They had a catalog out of North Carolina where it sells for $459 unpainted or $659 painted. I think that's what it said. I'll put the stats here on the screen. But I got this wire basket planter that I'm going to put somewhere. Let's just assume I don't know where any of this is going yet. I also got this really cute tricycle planter or pot holder. She's pretty rusty, but that's okay. We like patina here. Then we got an array of shepherd's hooks. Let me see if I can't get them organized a little. So, and I only got a few shepherd's hooks. I would say I got about a third of them. Mom got way more than I did. That's okay. Mom has a bigger garden than I have. She's also, despite being older than I am, she is the one who is not afraid at all. She was in the weeds pulling stuff out of this garden. I am telling y'all, this garden made me so sad because you could tell it was a couple acres and that it must have been beloved at one time. There were fountains and bird baths and shepherd's hooks. They had 2 greenhouses and a barn. There were tags. All of the garden beds were overgrown, but they had tags lining the garden beds where you could tell they at one time had beautiful flowers and plants of food. They had a whole food garden with, you know, herbs and tomatoes and vegetables and fruits, and it was just all overgrown. And I, you know, it is what it is, but it's so sad to think that at one time someone loved that garden. And I hope they never had to see it so overgrown. All right. So in amongst the shepherd's hooks, I did get this trellis with a little bird and a little squirrel. I'm not sure what I'm gonna grow on it, but I just thought it was so cute. They must have had, it was outside one of their greenhouses. They must have had a pretty vine on it at some point, but it just had a weeds growing around it now. Speaking of weeds. Excited for this one because it's short. I never get the short ones. Mom always gets those first. It's literally the first one I own. And the second one. Look how cute that is. one with a bird. So we got two tall ones, two medium ones, one with a bird, and two short ones. That's six shepherd's hooks. That's a pretty good size. A haul for what it is. I'm gonna have to bring all this down by my shed until I know where it's going. Then there were two other small trellises, but they were black. They didn't have the cute bird and squirrel on them. And Mom had thought they were for me, but maybe she decided to keep them because they're not in my pile. If she wants them, that's fine. I wanted that bird one. Then I got this. It's like a shepherd's hook trio with a little fleur-de-lis arrowy thing on top. I thought it was so cute. I love it. This one might be something that I put like on my porch to put small plants on. It's really cute. It's pretty sturdy. Then we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just literally like a tomato or plant stakes. Can see one of my next projects. I recently learned that you can put salt and pepper shakers on these instead of like the little upturned pots to protect your eyes. I just think that's cute. That's the whole project. I'm gonna do a video on it because I think that's adorable. And all those like little lost salt and pepper shakers that you find places. I mean, all right, so that's it. We've got six shepherd's hooks, one trellis, five stakes, one adorable shepherd hook trio, a basket, and a tricycle. Let's go ahead behind y'all and go through those things. So, over here we have a collection of things that just needs to be put away, but the things we got from the estate sale are this bird bath, which is super cute, the little cherub holding the bunny on top of it, does not go with it, but I kind of like it. I might leave it in there. We'll see. It's not in the best condition, but again, $150 for everything. Basically, that one was out back, like I don't even know how far it was in the woods. And he said, if I could get it out, I could have it. So why not? Free bird bath. Then I did get this very sad shovel and this super cute seahorse statue. Mom found this in one of the gardens. And then everything that was in this tote. So, got this little basket of fairy garden items, which I don't know exactly what, but I am going to do a fairy garden at some point. And I collected some things from this estate sale and from the last estate sale. I also got a pair of pruners that still work. They're quite rusty, but I'm hoping I can clean them up. And a cute, sweet little pot to put on my potting bench with little like flowers on it. Most of the things in here are fairy garden things. I did get this set of butterflies. I got two of these blue ones. One is inside this teal one. And then there was a yellow butterfly, a green frog, and a hummingbird. We split them up. I got three and Mom got three. A plant watering orb. This little garden statue thing that I don't care about, but Mom got for me. It says, bloom where God plants you. And I did think it might be a sweet part of a fairy garden. But these are the two I'm most excited about. a little bunny, and a literal birdhouse. This is the most exciting part. And there is a bird nest and a wasp nest inside. No wasps, but we'll have to clean that out. Don't really need to keep it in this blue tote anymore, but I put it all in there to carry it back up to the house from behind the greenhouses. Much easier than carrying everything one at a time. All right, I'm gonna bring y'all down to see the first fountain, and then you might be able to see a peek to the second fountain behind me. And I have one more giant shepherd's hook that's hiding down by the other fountain. Let's go. Beyond my arbor that is fallen down, I need to get some new rebar for it. You can see the first fountain. You can also see that Mom has decapitated her. Not on purpose, but she has. She's a pretty fountain though, very heavy, and it has like a shell basin, a deep pedestal. The break on this, it was literally broken coming from the top of the hill to the bottom. But it's a clean break. So I think if I can just get some concrete glue, I will be able to fix her. And then she'll be beautiful once again. In the meantime, I've just been putting her head right here so she doesn't get broken further. As you can see, she's a little too far down. The base of the pedestal that she was on was kind of Jenga'd together at the estate sale, and it completely disintegrated when we tried to get it out. I'm probably going to get a different pedestal to put her on, because when we filled this up with water, the water comes to about here. She's too far down. So this one needs a little work, but that's okay. In the meantime, while they are not set up nicely, you can see that I also got 1, 2 matching stone urn pedestal garden pots for either side of my shed. Those will be fun to plant up next year. All right, so here is the tall shepherd's hook. Got it resting on a tree, but you can see it has 4 at the top. Then it goes down to a single base, and it even has a squirrel stopper if you wanted to put bird seed on it. So I've put it over here by where I like to keep my bird feeders, and I thought maybe just do nicely kind of in the garden, or in the yard, I mean. I don't like to put bird feed in my garden because then it grows weeds and encourages animals like squirrels. But can see my new fountain. Tell me you wouldn't pay $100 for that. I love it. And it does have a pump. It appears to have all the working pieces. Now, I would not be shocked if the pump doesn't work and it needs a new pump and new tubing, but all the pieces are there. It goes from the top here down all the way through the bottom. And so if it was working, it would come out right here at the base of the turtle doves, go down into this basin. This basin would go down onto here and then fill up. There is a cork so that it does not drain through the bottom here. It would probably go over the side of this fountain. I don't think it would stop. So we'll have to see exactly if it is one that spills over the sides or if it one that stays in the middle here. It has the pump in the bottom here, so it may just return to the top and be a closed circuit, which is what I'm hoping. But y'all,
I'm so excited. I love it. I had my little bird bath here for a very long time, and she was pretty, but this is a whole other level.
I think for $150, I made out like a bandit. Honestly, I would have paid $150 just for this fountain. All the other stuff is gravy. Pretty good gravy though. I hope you liked this kind of video. If you did, let me know. It is hard to kind of film at the estate sales because you're running around trying to tag things and then pack it up. It's hot, you're in a panic almost. But I did do an estate sale video when we picked up the first fountain, and that video included the fountain that mom got. So I will link that below if you want to go check it out. In the meantime, thanks for hanging out with me, and I will see you in the next video.